Hey Jackals, today we'll take a look at how to automatically apply some motion trails to a video inside DaVinci Resolve. Now let's get digital. This is the clip that I'll be applying the effect to, and just like in the previous video, you can use the motion trails effect inside the cut page, go to the effects, type in motion, you can simply apply it by dragging it over the clip, you can do the same in the edit page, go to effects, type in motion, only this time you have to go to the open effects, put the motion trails onto the clip. You can do the same in the edit page with the clip selected and the playhead over the clip. Go to the fusion page, control space over shift space to open the select tools, type in motion, motion trails, hold the shift to automatically drop the node between these two nodes, and you'll always need to open the inspector tab to make the adjustments, and now I'll simply delete this node. And lastly, you can do the same in the color page by opening the effects, type in motion, and apply this to the clip. So you have four ways of applying the effect, and just use the page that you like to use the most. In my case, I'll do this in the edit page. So I'll disable the effect inside here, go to the edit page, apply it to this video clip. I can now disable the effects, and open the inspector tab, and inside the inspector tab, I have to go to the effects tab. Now I can adjust the trail length. This is how many copies we'll have. You can also increase this. So maybe 50 is a little bit too much. So I'll go down to 20. You can set the drop off, which can make a kind of a shadow. So in this case, I'll just set it to 0.25. And we have some advanced options. We have the global blend. This can also help with the shadows. But in this case, you may want to adjust the drop off and increase it back up. Then you have the move trail. I don't use these options, but you can use the soften to get a vignette kind of effect. But in this case, I'll just use the blend as one so that you can see the actual effect. So the soften can give you a vignette type of effect, but this is basically the border type. So if I set this to replicate or reflect, this will be different. In this case, it doesn't make any difference because I haven't adjusted any of the settings. Let's say that I'll rotate this and I set this to black. You can now see what this actually does. But if you just want a vignette type of effect, this is how you can do it within one effect. And in the advanced options, you have the composite gamma. You can use the timeline, rec.709, linear, or custom, but I just leave this to timeline. Now, if you want, you can also use Ctrl R. You can add some freeze frame to this if you want. You can also cut the clip at the end of the freeze frame and make a different kind of adjustment. And maybe I'll speed this part of the video clip and just cut the freeze frame so you only have the sped up clip. Maybe something like this. And what I could also do is with the freeze frame, as you can see, it still has the trails, so I can cut this clip here and simply disable the motion trails at this point. Well, actually, I can enable them. Just disable the trail length so that I keep the soft edge of the vignette. And let's see what effect we got. I-O and press Alt and forward slash. And that's how I can quickly apply the motion trails effect inside DaVinci Resolve. And if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel to get DaVinci Resolve and video editing content twice a week, and hit the bell notification icon so you know when my next video comes out. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.